Speed, safety, and range will be key features utilized in the next generation of electric VTOLs. But are these aircraft really viable, or are they just over-exaggerated pipe dreams? Well, let's find out with a whole new list of incredible new aircraft. Vertical Aerospace is yet another company which has developed several prototypes and is now working on the X4 platform. It'd probably be considered to be on the high end, as it utilizes a high level of automation, along with an all-electric powertrain developed with Rolls-Royce. Their X2 has already proven to be a viable flying craft, but their X4 should be able to carry 5 people to a 100-mile range at 200 miles per hour. It features a composite airframe with a high aspect ratio wing, which we will find out might be the key to future electric VTOL craft. Expect a commercial delivery will be within the next few years. At number 6, the MK4. Electric VTOL racers are becoming a real thing, and the MK4 leads the way with a 120 mile per hour speed and a 0 to 60 in 2.8 seconds. It flies for around 20 minutes on a battery, which is not very much, but the batteries can also be swapped in mere seconds. The company claims that the flying car will be equipped with the latest LiDAR and radar technology, which will maintain an effective barrier and racing form. The octocopter will also maintain stability in case of rotor failure. Once again, the pilots will also have enhanced AR visions, which will provide telemetry and performance data. The next position is a little bit extreme, and it's called the Speeder from Jetpack Aviation. Now, as we all know, flying motorcycles may not be the safest thing in the world, but the Speeder works on the latest technology developed through the company, and it's actually powered by powerful miniature turbines. Built for stormtroopers, each engine is gimbaled for jet rotation and quick stabilization. It also has proprietary flight software, which can maneuver different airframes and propulsion setups, which is definitely impressive for fast reacting turbines. The top theoretical speed is 300 miles per hour, but manned versions will probably be a little bit slower. Automated versions could be used in military applications and fly cargo 150 miles downrange in 20 minutes. This particular company is well experienced in making jetpacks, so it is highly probable we will see more developments with the Speeder in the very near future. And I prefer the SkyDrive. Now, this particular VTOL has been in development for some time, and their prototype model can fly for roughly 10 minutes, which is nothing impressive, but we will likely see increased times with improvements in storage technology. Once again, this hexacopter has several safety features, including stability with multiple rotor failure, along with a distributed power system. The SDO3 would be the company's answer to densely populated cities around the world, and it could be utilized as an autonomous taxi for passengers. At number 3, the Black Fly. Now, there are tons of electric vehicles coming out all the time, so it's tough to cover them all. However, the Black Fly is a very impressive proven aircraft with over 4,000 logged flights. It has 3 fail-safe systems, which includes stabilization with rotor failure, an isolated distributed battery system, and a ballistic parachute. So it definitely sets the bar for safety standards. The pilot has total joystick control, but it also has many drone features including return to home and geofencing. Excluding initial sales, the company plans to list the Black Fly for around the same price as an SUV, and if everything pans out, it could be a very marketable and reliable electric craft. Now, the next position is the Lilium Jet. And we have seen a very impressive evolution of this particular craft over the years with multiple improved variants. This particular aircraft utilizes ducted electric vectored thrust, which integrates the jets into the wing flaps, thus providing vertical takeoff and landing abilities along with a low noise profile, but it also has longer flight times as well. The jet can house 6 passengers and 1 pilot for a maximum range of 150 miles at a 175 mile per hour top speed. There are also many developments on multiple fronts, including a plan to build a silicon anode battery, along with a commercial deal which will sell the craft to a Brazilian airline. Once again, this company is fairly proven, and they should bring this commercialized craft to the market in 2024. Now, this will probably take a whole nother video, but one of the most extreme and controversial devices out there is the Copter Pack, Now, there's been a lot of skepticism about their video because many people believe that it was actually tethered, and the company's main website actually admits that the prototype is not quite self-sufficient. Now, it would assumedly have some sort of autopilot ability, but not much more information has been revealed about this particular craft. Regardless, this will probably increase flying humanoid sightings around the world. As you know, many companies come out with cutting-edge concepts with impressive numbers, but many of these designs do not actually come to fruition. So it's appreciative to see a company like Joby Aviation design an upper-end electric vehicle, do their own due diligence, and actually deliver. This particular prototype can fly over 150 miles on a single charge, which definitely sets the standard for electric VTOLs. And they did this with achieving the right battery chemistry with their NMC cathode and graphite cathode. This has allowed them to achieve the perfect formula for optimal takeoffs and specific energy to fly 150 miles, but it's also capable of 10,000 flight cycles. Now, this aircraft is also impressive and can achieve 200 mile per hour speeds with 4 passengers. Ultimately, this is a game changer, and it eliminates the shortfalls in electric VTOLs with long range and adequate power ratios. If everything goes well, it should be commercialized around 2024. But I would also like to know what you think about all these aircraft. So please leave a comment, like the video if you enjoyed it, and also make sure to subscribe to my channel.